Hey, what's up? I'm Leonardo with Code Pink. I'm here in a hotel in La Paz, Bolivia, where we're about to meet with the TSC, the nation's electoral Supreme Court, the highest authority regarding elections here. And we have a full day agenda where we're going to talk to political analysts and speak with members of political parties and also get orientation as to how to be an electoral observer in the country. I got here on Wednesday. The elections are on Sunday. We've already spoken with a few experts who expressed some concerns already. Among them is the new quick count program. It's called DiPrepe, I believe. And there are concerns that it hasn't been tested and that it's going to be used to kind of, you know, set a narrative in the media about who the actual winner is, despite the fact that the full count, the full results, won't be known until Wednesday, which is October 21st. Another thing they've expressed concern about is the fact that voting is going to be timed, basically, in the sense that if your ID, your national ID, ends in a 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4, you have to vote in the morning. If it ends in 5 through 9, you have to vote in the afternoon. People said that in rural areas, this is going to cause a bit of a problem because people in rural areas tend to vote early, and hopefully they won't be turned away from the polls. The TSC has already said that nobody should be turned away from the polls for this reason, that the precautions were put in place because of COVID to prevent, you know, long lines and big crowds at polling stations. And yet another concern we heard is about the fact that in many places, in polling stations, some of the political parties won't have representation. And there's a concern that this could lead to, you know, small frauds in particular polling centers. So that's one of the things that we're going to look out for here as electoral observers. Code Pink is here as part of a delegation. And our goal here is to follow the law and to ensure or help ensure that the Bolivians have free and fair elections. Thank you.